It's HJ. Oh, I'm back. And I'm excited to be talking to you guys about something that frustrates me. It's funny because it frustrates me when other people do it, but then I do it with my husband a lot. I hate when you're having a conversation and you're like, hey, I didn't like the way that you were snappy with me earlier. And then maybe the other person comes back. Yeah, well, you're always short-tempered, or like you're always angry, or like, yeah, well, you're always fill in the blank. They're like trying to throw up a wall with pride and like masquerade and be like, yeah, well, you always, and like throw it back on you. Doing this is actually really detrimental in three key ways. And that's something I wanna talk to you about. It's not just like, don't shift the blame and don't throw things back on people because it's rude. It's deeper than just rude. Three things happen whenever we throw it back on other people. One, we are not accepting correction and criticism in a godly way. Two, we are making other people's sin a moral standard for us instead of Christ as a standard. And three, we are making light of sin. And anytime you make light of sin, you make light of God's holiness. So those are the three things I want to talk about on what happens in our heart whenever we shift blame. Okay, step one. I mean, not step one, thing one. Proverbs 19:20 says, listen to advice and accept correction, and in the end you will be wise. Okay, we need to be good listeners. One of the main ways that God causes us to grow in godliness is through other Christians in our life. And whenever somebody is actually calling out your sin, calling you to repentance, and calling you to be more like Christ, that is God's grace on your life. If he didn't love you and he didn't want to see you grow, he would let you sit in your sin and never call and beckon you through other Christians to put your sin away and change. So we need to be good stewards and good responders to godly challenge in our life, and thank the Lord when it happens, like, man, God, you love me. Proverbs 12:1 says, whoever loves discipline loves knowledge, but he who hates reproof is stupid. That's not my word, that's God's word. I didn't call you stupid. We like to fire back really quick. Oh yeah, well, you always do this. Yeah, you say that, but you did this last week, because it's discipline. And especially coming from me and where I've been in life, alone on my own since 16, having to be an adult, having misguided or misplaced discipline as a child, I'm getting way better, but especially in my teens, like, I did not like authority. I did not like anyone to tell me what to do, and I was real feisty about it if somebody did. And I cannot be like that as a godly person, because a fool, a stupid person, despises gaining wisdom. So if you say that you love the wisdom of God, you have to love and accept the correction that comes along in your life to bring about more wisdom in your life. God says if you don't, then you're foolish. It's hard, but that's what the Holy Spirit's for. I'm not saying it's easy, and like every time somebody says, hey, you don't look like Christ in this area, you're just gonna be like, yes, tell me all about how I don't look like Jesus. I wanna look more like him. Maybe sometimes he will, but a lot of time our sinful pride bubbles up first, and we have to be like, no, 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 help me, help me. And he will. Like, the Holy Spirit wants to see you look like God more than anybody else. So he will help you, and he will help give you patience and kindness and gentleness and wisdom in those moments whenever somebody's giving you guidance and correction. So whenever we turn the finger back around, like somebody's pointing at our sin and we try to turn it back to them, what we're actually doing, whether we notice it or not, we are making other people's sin a standard for us to compare our sin to, instead of making Christ the standard to compare our sin to. Saying something like, oh, well, it's not that bad, or at least it's not like them, or at least it's not like what they did, is one of the most theologically wrong and a very damaging thing that we can do, because we're making somebody else's worse sin make us feel better about our sin. And this is scary, because when we do that, it becomes so easy to put ourselves in a position where we don't even have to ever feel bad about anything that we do that's ungodly, because there's always gonna be somebody. Look at the news. Look at any newspaper. There's always going to be somebody who is a worse sinner than you that will make you feel good about yourself. Like, yeah, I don't pay my child support, but I didn't murder anybody. Like, what? We can falsely be filled with pride and think like we're good, we don't need anything. And that is a very muddy territory to travel. We need to fess up. We need to own up. We need to repent to who we've hurt. We need to repent to the God, the holy God we've sinned against. Which leads to the third point. We start to minimize sin whenever we hurry up and shift the blame, or we look and compare our sin to somebody else. We minimize it. And anytime we minimize our sin, whether we realize it or not, what we're actually doing is minimizing the glory of God. Sin is only sinful because of the holiness of the God we're sinning against. I know I'm saying the word sin a lot, and I hope that's not freaking you out, but it's something that we need to be comfortable saying. Like, talking about sin is a good thing. Talking about putting away sin and striving for holiness and living a life that is holy as God has called us to be is a good thing to talk about. So don't let it scare you. If it does, maybe say it a little bit more. Get used to it a little bit. I love you guys. I just want to encourage you. Love wisdom, love discipline. God disciplines those who he loves.